Hello guys, this is Amon Style Music, and in today's lesson, I'm going to teach you how to play Georgie, also known as George Miller, also known as Filthy Frank, okay? The song, very awesome song called Foie Bump. Okay, I think it's Foie Bump. It's spelled F-O-I-E and then bump, okay? I think that's how you pronounce it, but anyway, it's pretty awesome sample loop I'm going to teach you. It's like this piano loop thing. I'll give you a preview of what it sounds like before we start learning how to play it, okay? So check it out. I'll play it an octave higher than usual, so it just sounds, I guess. Okay, actually, no. I'll play the original and just have a listen to how it sounds like first. It goes like this. Loops like that. So it loops infinitely like that. But anyway, I'm going to teach you how to play this. I'll play it one octave higher so you can see all the notes and stuff. So let's go ahead and start the lesson. Okay, so the right hand, it starts with the D sharp. So normally it was the D sharp just above middle C right here. But for the lesson, I'm going to give you the notes on like this D sharp. So it's one octave higher so you can see all the notes here and see all the notes on the left hand as well. But anyway, okay, so it's very interesting. The first note is D sharp. Then D sharp again, twice, and then it goes down to C, C sharp. Okay, so that's the first part, okay? So one more time for the first part. So the first part, five notes for the right hand, it goes D sharp, D sharp, D sharp, and then C, C sharp. Okay, the reason why we want to do the D sharp with the fifth finger here is because the chords, there's only one chord for the left hand, but the left hand, the chord actually combines with the right hand as well because it's a pretty big chord and I like to voice it like this, okay? So, the first chord, for this first part, there's only one chord and the chord is C minor, kind of like a 9, okay? So, C minor 9, so I like to voice it this way, so it's the combination of left and right hand, it goes like this, okay? So, the C sharp below middle C, and then B, that's the left hand, and the right hand continues the E, G sharp, B, and up to the D sharp, which is the first note of the melody. Okay, so that's the first chord. So it kind of combines the chord with the melody, okay? But anyway, with that in mind, yeah, that's pretty much it. You hold that chord and then continue with the melody. Like that. Remember the melody? If it starts with the D sharp, it combines with the chord. So pretty much one more time. So it just goes like this. This is the first part. So it's like together. Like that. Okay, and you can like kind of arpeggiate it if you want as well. Can you do it like this? Like that? Okay, so slow version of what happened just then. This technique, arpeggiating like the chord and rolling it. Basically, you do the lowest note to the highest notes. Like that. So it's like the lowest on the left hand. And then roll up. So in the essence, it's just like separating all the notes from lowest to highest. When you do it faster and hold it, it sounds more better like this. A lot of kind of like, I guess, intermediate pianists they do. And I kind of do it in my covers a lot as well. So it's like that. Just like a wave, okay? Make sure you get it smooth, not like, or like that's not that good. So make sure just flow into it like that, okay? So basically, that's the first part for the two hands. Anyway, the second part and the pretty much the last part before the like the cycle and repetition of the loop goes like this, okay? Right hand goes from the C, C sharp up to the A up here. And then A, B, G sharp down to the B and then C. And that's it for the right hand for the second part before the loop, okay? One more time. So it goes up to the high A, A again, B, G sharp down to B, C natural, like that, okay? Just like that. So that's the right hand for the second part. Okay, the left hand, the chords. Okay, so once again, the left hand and the right hand combines the chords together, so it's quite important. So yeah, I'll just show you quickly what happens here. Basically, left hand, lowest note is G sharp, F sharp, and the right hand goes A, C, E, and up to the high A, which is the first note of the melody, remember, of the right hand. So like that. That's the whole chord, okay? Combined with the left and right hand. Okay, so with that in mind, this chord is actually, let me see. It's basically, this chord is A, No, not A. G sharp augmented fifth with the extra sixth, the F sharp, okay? Okay, actually no, this is a seven, my bad. So G sharp augmented fifth with the added seven, okay? So it's like da and then like that, okay? So, okay. So with that chord in mind, basically you hold the chord and then you continue with the melody. Like that, that's the second part. Okay, so like that. So remember the first note is A, that's the first note of the melody, but it's also the chord as well at the same time. So it's like together, two, three, like that. Okay, so that's it for the second part. That's pretty much it. Okay, so make sure you get the rhythm right. It's like together, two, three, four, like that. Okay, so together, two, three, four, like that. Okay, so that's the second part. So yeah, going back. And then we loop back to the first part, and then second part, first part, second part, just like that, okay? So, with the proper rhythm, just goes like this. Together, two, three, four. Together, two, three, four. Together, two, three, four. Together, two, three, four. Like that, okay? So make sure you get the rhythm like that, and after that you can kind of like bounce on each like rhythm and the the chord note with the right hand at the start. I like to do it like this, just like my cover, like this. Something like that, I guess. Yeah, just I guess try it out for yourself and try it one octave lower, like what it sounds like on the original. So like this. Much it, okay? Hope you enjoy learning this awesome catchy little song. Well, it's not really a song, it's more like a sample of the Georgie's Foy Bump. Okay, that's the song name. But yeah, anyway, check out more of my piano covers on like Filthy Frank covers and my Georgie songs and stuff. Like I've done a lot of them in the past. Pretty awesome. He's like, I guess, pretty awesome taste in music, and his music productions, his songs are very awesome, okay? But anyway, check those out. Probably search on the channel, search by, like, you know, when you go to my main channel, and this is extra, like, search bar within my channel, you can search that and just search, like, the song name or the artist, and you pretty much, like, find all the ones that I've done, okay? But anyway, as for now, I guess, enjoy your time around my channel, and I guess, see you next time. Hello guys, as a reward for watching my video right to the end, here is what I have for you. If you want to learn how I can play any song in the world, including this one in this video, within 10 to 20 minutes just by listening, then click the first link in the description below to preview my Ear Mastery book for free. Click the second link for my beginner's course if you are completely new to the piano and don't know where to start. Click the third link for my library of popular full song video lessons membership. Or click the fourth link for my paid piano request and full song tutorial service if you want me to personally play any song for you or make a full song tutorial for you. And finally, if you are a sheet music learner who wants to learn a specific song or arrangement where the sheet music is not available anywhere in the world, then click the fifth link for my sheet music transcription service where I will personally write it out for you. As for now, like this video, subscribe, enjoy your time around my channel, and see you next time.